Let's understand verbal section in the CET examination. Let's get begin with it. Let's start with sectional analysis. Now guys, you're going to get logical reasoning, verbal ability slash reading comprehension, quantitative aptitude, and abstract reasoning. So you've got these four topics on which there are going to be 200 questions, as we all know, and the time is 150 minutes. Now guys, CET examination is not about accuracy, it's just about time management. That means in 150 minutes out of 200 questions, the more you can get right, the better your chances are to get the maximum percentile. So let's understand about verbal ability, reading comprehension in this small recording. Now guys, this is the most important part of this recording. Not just I'm going to talk about the topics in the verbal section, but also the number of questions asked. Now in RC passages, that means in reading comprehension, you're going to get around 15 questions. Okay, in para jumble, you guys are going to get 5 questions. Usage of phrases, that means they are going to give you 3 sentences, 5 options are going to be given for each sentence. You have to find the right one. So you're going to get 3 questions on the phrases. Usage of phrases, rewrite the sentence with same meaning. Of course, as the name suggests, is self-explanatory. You're going to get 2 questions on it. Antonym and synonym combination, opposite word, similar word, you're going to get around 2 questions on it. So you're going to get 2 questions on antonym synonym. Let me write 2 in a better way, better than what I did it earlier. Spot the error sentence correction, that means on grammar, you're going to get around 13 questions. Okay, fill in the blanks. Again guys, fill in the blanks, antonym, synonym, these all questions are basically focusing on vocab. You're going to get 3 questions on fill in the blanks. Sentence joiners and match the following. You have to join sentences, or maybe which option can start the sentence without changing the meaning, questions like that. So you're going to get around 7 questions there. So this is the breakup in verbal section. In 2018, you got 15 questions on RC, 5 questions on para jumble. Usage of phrases, you got 3 questions on it. Rewrite the sentence with same meaning, 2 questions on it. Antonym and synonym combination, 2 questions on it. Spot the error sentence correction, on grammar you got 13 questions. Fill in the blanks, you got 3 questions. Sentence joiners and match the following, you got 77 questions on it. Now guys, I have seen many times people ask me, and people are speculating how many questions are going to be easy, how many questions are going to be difficult or medium. Now let me tell you guys, at least 23 questions are going to be easy. Out of 50 questions in verbal section, you got 50 questions, and out of 50 questions, 23 questions are very easy to solve. 19 questions are going to be of medium level. That means if you are average in English, you can solve those questions. And 8 questions are going to be difficult. Now, to cross more than 40 marks in verbal section, you need to be good in English. However, anyone, if anybody has studied little bit verbal while preparing for the entrance exam, can easily score more than 25 marks out of 50 questions, guys. Verbal section is easy, I agree. Now, how the verbal section will help you to make sure that you score maximum in the least possible time, I will explain it to you in the later part. Let's go ahead with it. Let's talk about the approach in the verbal section. Now, verbal section is less time consuming. Now, why it's less time consuming, I tell you. Now, imagine you got a question on reasoning, and you got a question on quant, and then you got a question in verbal section. Maybe you can solve a question in reasoning or not. For that, you have to start solving it. Of course, it is time consuming. You have to first read the question, analyze it, understand it, and then you will start solving it. Now, maybe you are able to solve it or not, but then this thing will take and consume time. Similarly, assume that if there is a question on quant, take topic of your preference. Maybe let's say if you're good in Time and work. There is a question on time and work. Of course, you need to read, understand, analyze what needs to be calculated, and then you're going to find the answer. Now, in verbal section, you got one question and sentence correction. You read the sentence, either you know the answer or you don't know the answer. Now, guys, the best part of verbal section in CET examination is this, that this section won't be consuming much time. That means if you are good in verbal, in 25 minutes, you can easily target more than 30 questions. Correct 30 questions. Of course, you're going to attempt all the questions because there is no negative marking. But if you are good in verbal, easily anyone who is above average in verbal or English can score more than 30 marks. Because as I've already mentioned, 23 questions are going to be very easy. 19 questions are going to be of medium level. Now guys, this analysis is based on CET 2018. In 2019, we can expect few changes, but not on a bigger scale. So let's understand about why this section is important and how you guys can score good. Now guys, let me tell you, if your verbal is not up to the mark, if your verbal is weak, you can definitely score more than 93 percentile banking on quant and reasoning. But then you can never cross more than 95 percentile. The reason is simple. You just got 150 minutes. Now guys, understand, in 150 minutes, if you got 200 questions to solve and you have to cross 125 or 130 barrier to get more than 99 percentile. No matter how good you are in reasoning, no matter how good you are in quant, you cannot solve more than 100 questions in 150 minutes. Now, why I'm telling you this, guys? Because verbal is the section which is very less time consuming as compared to any other section. Either you know the answer or you don't know the answer. If you know the answer, you tick the answer, you move on. If you do not know the answer, there is no point in thinking about it. In quant, whether you can solve it or not, in reasoning, whether you can solve it or not, it takes time to gauge that. Now, out of 50 questions, a candidate can easily target more than 35 right attempts in less than 30 minutes if you have prepared for it. Let's proceed further. Now, guys, the verbal section does not even stop there. There is a sidekick of the verbal section. Now, you are going to get critical reasoning, family tree, questions requiring understanding of the language. Of course, there are going to be questions. Now, these questions, guys, are going to be in either reasoning section or miscellaneous reasoning section. Now, to solve these questions, you need to understand the language. If you are getting confused in the word formation, in the sentence formation, you can never be able to solve these questions. So, guys, I'll summarize what I just explained. In verbal section, out of 50 questions, your target should be minimum 30 attempts in less than 30 minutes, or I'll say 35 attempts in 30 minutes. Out of 50 questions, 23 questions are going to be very easy, 19 questions are going to be of mediocre level, and 8 questions are going to be difficult. At CET King will help you to achieve this target. Thank you guys, and best of luck.